My name is Fran Henderson, and I'm the founder of New Hope Equine Ministries. We're here today with Mattia Knight, and we're just going to find out some things from her that she's experienced this summer. Mattia, what brought you to us this summer?
Well, my youth pastor sent out an email to see if anybody wanted to help work with horses, and I thought that was cool, so I thought that I would say yes.
Yeah, I like that.
Which horse do you find has the biggest sense of humor?
No, Scout maybe, Sad.
Who is your favorite horse to ride?
I have a few. I like riding Satin and Beauty and Big Red and some other horses.
Yeah? What do you like about Big Red?
He's a big horse and he's gentle and calm and he's easier to control sometimes than others.
Okay. How about Beauty?
I like how she lopes and trots.
Yeah.
She's a good trotter.
What's your favorite time that you spent with the horses?
Well, one of our last staff trail rides when we got a gallop, that was really fun.
Yeah? How about the first time you galloped?
Well, we got to gallop and we kind of started off at a trot and then we went into a lope and then they just kind of all started galloping and it was kind of like, what are they doing? And we couldn't get really to stand because we were like so surprised that like just like went so with it. It was really kind of hard to stay standing, but we got to stand a little bit, which is fun.
How did you handle it emotionally, riding for the, like, trot and galloping for the first time?
We just laughed. it was good, though.
Sometimes the first time you go into a new gear like that is kind of scary, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah. It wasn't really scary, though. It was just more funny than anything.
Yeah. The first time I galloped, I cried. Did you cry too?
Not when I galloped.
You liar, pants.
No, when I loped.
Yeah, when you loped.
Didn't cry when I galloped.
No?
No.
Oh, okay. Now that someone knows where you come from, doesn't care where you've been, he can put back pieces that you lack, make you whole. What did you learn this summer that you didn't know before?
I learned how to saddle up horses and brush them and clean them and stuff. And
okay.
Eat them and ride.
So when we were at camp, what was the first thing we would do in the morning?
We would go and catch the horses and then brush them.
What kind of brushes would you use for brushing your horse?
We would use a curry comb, a mane and tail comb, and dandy brush and a hoof pick.
So you learned how to pick up horses' feet and pick their feet?
Yeah.
Which is easier, the front feet or the back feet?
Front feet.
What's the next thing you do with your horse?
We go and get the saddles and we saddle them up.
And how do you do that?
Well, you take the blanket and you put it on their back and put the pad on top and then the saddle and you do it up.
And okay.
Take the bridle and put the bit into their mouth. And then you put the crown over top of their ears.
Okay.
Do the throat latch up.
So do you just kind of stick it out there in front of the horse and just pop it in their mouth? How do you do that?
No, you have to guide it into their mouth. You stick your finger into the ring on the bit and and you stick your finger into their mouth and tickle their tongue, and they open their mouth and you pull it in.
Do you stand beside them and put them in a headlock? And
yeah.
Then what do you do?
We untie them and we walk them around for a bit, and then we tighten their saddles.
And why would you do that? Why wouldn't you just tighten their saddle as they stood there after you put it on?
Because sometimes they hold their breath and you can't get it tight enough, and if you're riding, you could slide sideways.
Ah, that sounds like something you don't want to do. Okay. So once you've gotten your horse walking around in the arena and you've checked the saddle, now what do you do? How do you get up on the horse?
You grab onto, hold onto the reins and the horn and the back of the saddle, and you put your foot into the stirrup and you jump and swing your leg over top and put your foot into the other stirrup.
Okay. Now once you've gotten up there, how do you sit on the horse?
Sit up straight and push your feet forward so that you don't hit their sides.
Okay. Is there a little saying that we had this summer?
Yeah.
And what's that saying?
Heels down, toes to the nose, squeeze with your knees and shoulders back, please.
That's right. Now my next question is, if you don't have a saddle on, how do you get on that horse?
Well, you hold on to the reins and a bit of their mane, and then you put your hand on the back and you jump and swing your legs over. Leg over.
Leg over? Both legs?
Just one leg.
Just one leg? Now, you want to reverse. Now, that's one of the things we hear in the show rings and such like that. How do you do a reverse?
You pull on the reins and you do a circle, kind. You do half of a circle and go the other way.
Okay, so it actually is what it says. You reverse the direction that you're going. I know you're out there. Brushes, when you use the curry comb, how do you use that? What do you do?
You start at the top where the mane is, at the very top, and then you go in tight little circles down, and you go back to the top and go back down until, and you go right under their stomach. You just do tight little circles to get all the dust and dirt.
What do you do next with the other brush? What brush is that?
We use the dandy brush and we do it like in a sweeping motion, so to brush the all that stuff off of their fur.
How do you comb the hair? Like, is it the same as with people or?
Not really. You kind of scratch at the top because there's like dirt up on the mane, and like you scratch at the top of it, mm-hmm. and then you kind of brush down so that you don't get any knots, like from the bottom up. And then you just keep doing that till you're done.
Okay. And how about with the tail? How's the best way that you've found to comb the tail out?
To put it on my leg and brush it on my leg, and then you know that you've got most of the knots out.
Do the horses enjoy having their tails brushed?
Yeah, they like it because sometimes they can get really itchy.
How do you pick up the horse's feet?
Well, there's a little tuft of hair at the bottom. You put your foot between their two legs, mm-hmm. and then you go down their legs so that they know what you're doing, and they kind of grab that tuft of hair and lean into them so that you're like kind of pushing them over. You pick the hoof up and then you start picking it.
How do you hold that pick, and how do you pick?
You hold it kind of like this and you pick down. You don't pick up, or else you can jam. You can like jam stuff into their hoof, which you don't want.
Do they appreciate that, or do they swat you with their tail sometimes? And
they like having their feet cleaned most of the time. Sometimes they'll swing their tail at you and stuff, but it's
more to play with you than, than be mad at you. When you're out on the trail ride, and there's a whole big line of you, do you talk to each other and that sort of thing?
Well, you usually want to kind of not really be too loud and stuff. You just want to control your horse, but you do, if there's a car coming, you want to say car so that you can warn the other people that there's something coming or dangerous.
Safety equipment for you. What do you wear for safety?
We wear helmets for when we're riding and covered toes, shoes, and jeans.
Yeah? Have you ever fallen off your horse?
Yeah, a few times.
When you were at camp this summer, did you learn how to fall off a horse?
Yeah.
And how's that?
You lean forward and you let go of the reins and you lean forward and then you swing your leg over and you kind of jump down and then roll so that your horse doesn't step on you.
God in my living, fear in my breathing, God in my waking, God in my sleeping, God in my resting, fear in my working, God in my thinking, God in my speaking, be my everything, be my everything, be my everything.